everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about the application of technology. We get a lot of calls, obviously, every day, room forums and stuff like that. I see a lot of misunderstanding here. So we're going to walk you through a process we go through, a rough process, so you kind of get an idea of what you're up against in terms of what kind of treatment do I use, type, how much of it do you use, and obviously, where do I put it? So we know type, amount, position, our acronym TAP. What type? Well, we have absorption and diffusion. Those are the only two that we can use, right? So, and under those, we have pressure and reflections. So how are we going to treat pressure with diffusion? We're not. Absorption. How are we going to treat pressure with absorption? That's what we're going to talk about. So that's what we need to look at. So absorption, what frequency range and what amplitude is the problem? That's what we have to kind of figure out. So where is the problem? Maybe it's one frequency, but it's usually a range. So let's look at a typical curve here. We call that the camel's hump. It's that double peak we always see in small rooms. And it can be, you know, it can be plus 12 dB, plus 4. I saw some the other day, plus 16. And you got two of them. So it's usually 30, 40, 50, somewhere in there. And then it falls below like 70, 80, below baseline, and you get a dip. So we got peaks and dips. We want middle, remember, we want balance. So that's our goal. So we got to push on those peaks. We got to absorb this excess energy created by that particular dimension. So let's take an example. Let's say we have a 12 dB peak, 40 hertz, and it's on the short wall. We have to know that. Okay, so we got a 40 hertz problem on our 14 foot wall, let's say, and it's plus 12, plus 13. Okay, what treatment type are we going to use? TAP. So let's figure out the type. Well, all of our low frequency absorption is diaphragmatic. So that's what we're going to use. So we know our ACDA 12 series is 12 square feet. And whether it's the 10 or the 12, it attenuates about 1.5 dB in that 30 to 50 cycle range for the 12s. Okay. So that's our attenuation. So let's take our plus 12 dB peak and divide it by 1.5 dB because that's about the amount of energy each 12 square feet or each unit absorbs. So it's 8 units. Remember, it's two walls, not one, but two walls that cause the problem. So we have to divide that 8 units by two. So it's 4 units on each wall, about 50 square feet. And that's about an average start for this situation that you see there. We can increase the higher, get a higher resolution. We have to add more units, more coverage, more amount. Right? When we're going back to our acronym of TAP. So that's how we do it. Now that'll get a 70-75% resolution if we do that across the whole room and the floor to ceiling dimension. So those are the three sound fields that we have to focus on. Want a higher resolution? We add more square footage of coverage. 70, 80, 90, those are the three resolutions of rooms that we provide. So since it's a two-wall issue, we put 4 on each wall, like I said, 50 square feet, and that's our start point. We want a higher resolution, and we don't have any more footprint or more space to give up. We stack on top. We make modules. We can help you with figuring all that out. So we've had 17 years of data, 400 rooms that we built and measured, so we have a really good handle on your room size and volume and what it takes to fix. Now, in about 90% of the cases, people can't afford to fix, you know, to the maximum resolution that they'd really want. Okay, well, then we pick a resolution that works for budget. You can always add more. You can always work your way up to a higher resolution. It's more square footage of coverage, especially when it comes to low frequency pressure problems. Reflections, not so much, but we'll talk about that in another video. So how do we figure all this out? Well, you don't have to. Fill out the room form. Go to the homepage, acousticfields.com, and in the upper left-hand corner, there's a tab that says Room Analysis. Fill out all the information in that, and then send it to us, and then follow the instructions and schedule a phone call. Once I have the data in front of me, I can start using all of our data to help you and figure that out. So, technology application. Hope this helps. Thank you.
Thank you for watching this video, and if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to, so please do that because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions, and I usually get a chance every couple of days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum, and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis, so that'll help you. Thank you.